All right, so some pictures for you from the World Championships currently going on in Morocco. Team Nigeria struggling with the girls, but then pulling their weight with the guys. And the most important thing is that these people are gathering experience. They're gaining plenty of experience. Some of them have never traveled out for a tournament like this before. Now they are gaining valuable experience that will help them as they progress in their different career. We will, of course, keep our eyes on it and continue to update you with all that is coming out of Morocco. You can see the Team Nigerian guy really giving as much as he's taking as well in that one. All right, so away from table tennis now, let's come back to football. And Toby, Canopilas eventually got their trophy at the annual General Assembly of the Nigerian Football Federation. You saw the game, Canopilas against Enyimba. Why do they always fail to perform the Charity Cup? I can't remember the last time Pilas won a Charity Cup. They win the league, Charity Cup,
And they started the game.
The other time it was Atlanta that beat them.
Yep,
this time it's Enyimba that beat them 2-0.
And you know, they started the game, you know, in a very good mode. At least dominated for 15 minutes before Enyimba came on, you know, to dominate possession or to get to go from Ifeanyi Ndeaye and Sibigua. But it was not a bad performance from the Pilas. I think maybe they were filled, you know, plenty of joy. They wanted to, you know, lay their hands on the trophy because at halftime the LMC presented the trophy to them.
Oh, they got this trophy. This is a trophy presentation that they got the trophy for the 2012-2013 season of the Global Cup Premier League. And that's the beautiful trophy going to Pilas for winning. And maybe when they got this, there was no hunger fight for the Charity Cup.
They won't go down because, you know, funny enough, you know, at halftime, they were hungry. They just wanted to touch the trophy. They were happy, you know. They are coming in. They want to prove something. They want to prove stuff, especially for Imama, who has been tested. And, you know, they came on in the second half. Sibigua scored the second goal. But it was not a very bad performance for them. I think that led to
But let's talk about Pilas, Toby. Baba Ganaru has been confirmed out. They are shopping for a new technical advisor.
Yeah, interestingly, Baba Ganaru moved to Nasarawa United. But for Pilas, there's been rumor.
And that's the picture. It's the confirmation that Baba Ganaru has joined Nasarawa United. That's the chairman of Nasarawa United, barrister Isaac Danladi. And that's Baba Ganaru, former Pilas, now holding the jersey of Nasarawa United. He's going to be in charge of Nasarawa United for the new season. I hope he has not left the magic in Kano. That's what I'll be hoping.
It's disappointing how Baba Ganaru actually left. He actually said some things after the league ended, when he won the league.
Most of
our coaches
already tell you left after that. Of
course, I don't understand, but of course, we really have to respect his opinion. And he has moved over to Nasarawa. He's struggling Nasarawa United. One would have expected that he will actually move to one of the top clubs in the Nigerian professional.
What makes you think that Nasarawa is not the top club?
They struggled. They actually... It has actually transformed.
Maybe that's why they brought him.
That's why they transformed. Yes. That's why they won the league with Pilas back to back. Kadri Kana, Salisu, he was with Ekanemi, had plenty of experience.
He's maybe, gone everywhere.
Come down to and transform Nasarawa United to a winning team. Who knows? But Nasarawa United is struggle, like, you know, Kole said, just 2 points off the relegation. So, but it matters this extent. They retain their status. Baba Ganaru, with plenty of experience, might come there. Good players and turn things around. Maybe they'll compete for titles or pick a contender at the end of the season.
Well, for Rangers, also during the week, over the weekend, they announced that they have a new chief coach who will assist John Obu. And Christian Chukwu is also back as a technical consultant. Rangers have struggled to win anything in a long time. And I'm afraid that if it continues, I don't know. Must they do to win something?
They just
Rangers.
Have to break the jinx. And reason why they wanted to maybe, you know, change their technical career, Modi was there last year. You know,
and they started this season like a house on fire. This was the first game of the season when they beat Enyimba 1-0 in Enugu. And we felt that after finishing second the previous season, this was going to be
the
season for
Rangers. And, you know, on the continent also, they had a very, you know, proper performance drop from the, you know, captain.
The team that they knocked out before they were disqualified.
Their transfer last season was shady. But John Obu, an experienced manager, and is a good head coach for him also. Let's see, maybe. They had very good players from the goalkeeping department. They have fantastic players at the back races. Teligani Pekoli was fantastic. At the middle, plenty of quality going forward also. I think they just need to bring in, you know, fortify, you know, some positions. And let's maybe John Obu could just transfer. The truth of the matter is Rangers want to win a title. He's been on the lead hands on a major title. And maybe picking a contender ticket for next season and also break that jinx. They are one of the traditional clubs in the league, and not winning a title for a very long time look disappointing for the management. Also, they are finding every way
for the state
also. So, what to just do everything like Dada? like I said, there are plenty of quality players in that one. Like you said, they started the season well. Defeated Yimba won't go to nothing at week one. Everyone expected them to come in for titles, end up with the corner ticket. But all those failed to happen.
They not even get the corner ticket.
They don't at the end of the season. So let's see what will happen this season. John Obu in there for them. Maybe it's going to be a very good decision for them as a technical advisor.
Well, Kunle, our teams on the continent, Kano Pillars looking for a coach, Yimba looking for a coach, El Kanemi Warriors looking for a coach. Only Bayelsa United looks settled.
Yes.
I mean, those are the four teams I'll be representing. Warri Wolves as well. They just brought in Paul Aibogun, a new coach. So I've not seen that stability that we'll probably see our Nigerian teams. And we don't even know when the league is starting yet.
Of course.
The NFF have given an extension to the LMC to continue what they're doing. But we don't know when the league will start. The issue of club licensing is also there. It's been extended till next year. But it is good for us to also start, so that we don't have problems
next year.
Yes.
So we don't even have an idea of when the league will start, so that our teams on the continent can put themselves in shape.
That's really very disappointing. I think the league management company really has to come to fore right now, because they've given them the 1 year extension that they wanted, and of course they really have to swing into action.
They
right
don't
now.
Want 1 year extension. The one year extension is for members. Let's not talk about the 1 year extension. That one is another issue. They are giving them an extension.
Yeah. So let them begin to work right now. Let's have the league running. Now, since the CAF has said the 1 year extension has been given for the licensing, I think it's very imperative that, apart from the fact that it's going to have an adverse effect on our clubs in the continent, let's not also forget the fact that CHAN will be taking place in East South Africa next year. And of course, if we don't start the league right now, our players might just
like last season, when almost all our teams crashed out early
because
yes.
they were much rusty.
Like
in the charity cup, you could see the way Yimba players were playing. Not an exciting game. The players are much rusty.
They just already put them together.
They get the struggle all 90 minutes. And you know, like you said, continuity in the technical crew of this, most of this thing that you know. Representing on the continent,
only one out of five representatives.
I don't know why Salisu will leave Yimba. That's you know all the job they do. You know, won the Federation Cup.
Paul Aibogun as well.
Paul Aibogun moving on to moving on to Warri Wolves.
They have their reasons.
The Baba Ghana should have still been at Kano.
They have their reasons.
We still need you know continuity is key.
You know, and once there's no continuity, that's why the league should start on time.
You said that
these teams can start playing games. We know their weak points, their strong points, so that we can have better representation.
I just want to remember that the continent. Last season it was a very poor one for the Nigerian teams on the continent. We might, you know, improve on that this season, and you know, teams that will represent us in as pedigree. But we're talking about a lot of negative. The league, we don't know where the league will kick off. The players are much rusty. You take them to the continental football.
New coaches. Against
teams that you know they play regular football week where they look active. No, it's going to be difficult for us to get results against such teams.
All right, that's what we expect, and we hope that the LMC, the club owners, the NFF will sit, resolve all of these issues, let the league start, so that these teams can get busy, and then we have good representation for Nigeria in the different CAF club competitions that will be taking place next year. Let's read a few comments on Twitter before we wrap up Sports Tonight this Monday. Abdujalil Adeniran, top beach soccer referee, says Switzerland does not have a single beach, but they have a successful beach league. Just what Tunde said. And he says, all we need is determination and commitment. Just what Tunde said. So, Eko, Beach Soccer League starting is in line. Let's hope that that is the first step in that direction. Oshane Pinshegun, that's Pastor Shegun, says, Ture is so good, but couldn't win the Africa Cup of Nations. And Man City won a stick. Is saying, if Ture is so good, why didn't they win the Africa Cup of Nations? And why did Man City? One man cannot make a forest. Pastor Shegun. One man cannot make a forest, and that's what he says. Onia Aiswe says, we are spot on. Do you think Lagos is hosting the CAF Awards? Do you think an elephant will win it in Lagos? I don't think the venue has anything to do with it. Yeah. Venue has got nothing to do with it.
Yep.
National team coaches.
Adebayo won the African Best Player of the Year in Lagos.
Kanute won in Togo.
Yep. Yeah.
So venue has got nothing to do with it. There's no politics. Of venue in it, so
we're just hoping it might just be a blessing.
We're just hoping that the Nigerian winning will just cap it up for us on January 9. All right, so that's the much you can take. I'm told my time is up. Once again, congratulations to Yaya Toure, but let's hope that a Nigerian will do something with the CAF version of the awards. Gentlemen, time for us to move, but we'll close the show with highlights from the English Premier League. Was good for the Gunners. Yemi Adebayo is producing the show tonight, and it's very clear because he's bringing us highlights of how Arsenal beat Cardiff 3-0 over the weekend. Enjoy the rest of the night. We'll see you tomorrow.